Welcome to Excel Campus. My name is John, and in this video, I'm going to explain how to add a table of contents to your workbook that updates automatically. So here we have a simple table of contents sheet at the front of our workbook with clickable links to each sheet in the workbook. And whenever I make changes to the tabs in this workbook, whether I add or delete sheets or I rename a sheet, I want this table of contents to automatically update. And I have a macro that does this. I'll quickly show how it works. So if I just make a copy of this sheet here, left click and hold down the control key and drag this to the right, I now have a duplicate copy, remove duplicates too. And then when I click the table of contents sheet, my macro will run to automatically update my table of contents. And we can see that sheet has been added right here. So let's jump over to the VB editor and see how this macro works. Developer tab, Visual Basic button, keyboard shortcut is Alt F11. So I'm here in this file that contains my table of contents, and within the Microsoft Excel Objects folder, I have a list of all the sheet objects here within the file. And this one right here is my table of contents. So when we double click on that, we can see the code module window opens for that sheet object, and we have code in this sheet object. So we're using the worksheet activate event here, and this event or macro will run every time the user selects or activates this sheet. So I've added this by selecting worksheet here from the object dropdown, and then the activate event from the procedure dropdown here, and that will add in this macro right here for the worksheet activate event. And then within that, I've just added code to call a TOC list macro. And this macro is also within the sheet module, it's right down here, and this is the macro that just recreates the table of contents. So at first just clears all the cells on that sheet, and then it creates the title section, the header section there, and then loops through all of the sheets in the workbook to create the list with the clickable links or the hyperlinks. It also adds filters to the top there that allows your users to quickly sort the list or even search through it with the filter dropdown menus, applies a little formatting and auto fits the columns. So this macro runs every time the user selects the table of contents sheet. Now, if you have your own macro that creates a table of contents, you can just copy and paste it in here and then call it from the worksheet activate event. And I have a whole nother video that explains events and code modules in more detail. If you're not familiar with these events yet, I'll put a link to that in the description below this video. And again, it's important to note that this event will only run, the macro will only fire when the user selects this particular sheet that the code is in, which is the table of contents sheet. So if we jump back over to Excel here, let's just rename our sheet here or remove duplicates. We'll call this list uniques instead, hit enter. When I select these sheets, when I select any other sheets in the workbook, that macro is not running. But as soon as I select the table of contents sheet, the macro will run to recreate our table of contents. It runs really fast, and we can now see our new list uniques sheet listed right here in our table of contents. And it's also very easy to apply this to any other workbooks you have. Since the code is all in this code module, the sheet module, we can just copy this sheet to other workbooks. So in order to do that, I'll just show you how this works. I'm going to right-click the tab here, choose Move or Copy, and then we'll select another open workbook that we have on the computer. So just open the workbook you want to copy this to. I have one here called 200 Sheets. And yes, this workbook does have 200 sheets in it. Just wanted to show how quickly this runs. And then we'll put that workbook at the front. So before sheet one, we'll select the create a copy checkbox and then hit OK. That will copy the sheet to this workbook here. And you can see the macro also ran and listed out all the sheets in this workbook. And again, the code travels with this. So if we were to jump back over to the VB editor, we're in this workbook here, our 200 sheets workbook. Here's all the worksheets within it. Down at the very bottom, we'll have the TOC sheet. Just double click that. And we can see all the code has traveled here when we copied the workbook. I'm sorry, when we copied the sheet into this workbook, all the code comes with it. So we don't need to do any setup work besides just copying the sheet in here. If we go back over to Excel, we'll just change the names of one of these sheets, call this one data instead, hit enter. Again, select the table of contents sheet, and we can see the macro reruns, and we now have an updated table of contents. And of course, this is great if you or your users are constantly changing the sheets in your workbook, changing the names, or adding or deleting sheets, your table of contents will always automatically be updated to reflect what's in the workbook. The only other thing you'll have to do is make sure this is saved as a macro-enabled workbook with a .xlsm extension. And then when you or the user opens the workbook, you'll need to enable macros. And then every time you click or activate the table of contents sheet, that macro will run and give you an updated list of all of your sheets. And I also wanted to mention that this technique will work with my table of contents gallery macro. This macro creates a table of contents with clickable images to each sheet in the workbook. So we can just click these images here and that'll take us right to that sheet in the workbook. Now it does run a little slower because each time we click the TOC sheet, that's going to rerun the macro here. Takes a few seconds there to run and then updates all of the thumbnail images with all of the sheets in the workbook. So if you're using this macro and you want it to automatically update, you can definitely use this technique for that with a worksheet activate event. Just know it's going to be a little slower than if you use the regular sheet list macro. That one runs within a second or two. This is gonna take a few more seconds depending on how many sheets you have in your workbook. So hopefully that helps. Of course, if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. If you enjoyed that video, there are a few simple things you can do to help me out. If you're watching this video on YouTube, click the like button below the video and leave a comment with any questions or feedback. And please don't forget to subscribe to my free email newsletter to get more tips and tricks that will help you learn Excel. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.